In a previous video, I discussed olfactory receptors that are present in almost every tissue and organ in our body. So let's look today at light receptors. So in our skin, all over the body, there are two types of light receptors, melanopsin cells and what are called intrinsic photosensitive retinal ganglion cells, frequently referred to as IPRCG. Melanopsin cells help regulate our circadian rhythms, the cycle of night, day, in tandem with the earth rotating on its axis. And this is the circadian rhythm is our internal clock that controls our sleep-wake cycles. And IPRCG helps us to adjust to those cycles. It adjusts our pupils to changes in light levels. And they may also play a role in mood and pain perception. So mood, the light of the sun, and pain perception are entangled. Light receptors are also found in the brain, and there are several types of light receptors in the brain, including the IPRCGs that I mentioned. These receptors are involved in a variety of functions, including sleep, mood, and appetite regulation. Then there are light receptors in nerve endings. Light receptors are also found in the nerve endings of some animals, such as sharks. These receptors help the animals to detect changes in light levels, which can then be used for navigation and to find food. Other species also have extraocular photoreceptors. For example, some reptiles have light receptors in their skin that help them to regulate their body temperature. Birds have light receptors in their brain, and these help the birds to navigate during migration. Some fish have light receptors in their stomachs that help them to detect food. So, all over the place. The function of extraocular receptors varies depending on the species. In humans, they are primarily involved in regulating our circadian rhythms. However, they may also play a role in other functions such as mood, pain, perception, and sleep. In other species, extraocular photoreceptors may be involved in a variety of other functions such as navigation, feeding, and temperature regulation. Can I probably give you some more examples of this? So in humans, melanopsin cells in the skin help to regulate our circadian rhythm. As I mentioned, this is our circadian clock in birds, in sharks, in basically every species. Light regulates biological function. So what is the point of all this? The point is that the sun, the moon, the stars, you, me, all living forms on our planet. And of course, there's photosynthesis, which basically through quantum mechanics and quantum pathways, if there are any multiple pathways, are responsible for all of life on this planet, the photoreceptors in plants. So the point of all this is you, me, all life forms, including animals and plants, the sun, our moods, our sleep-wake cycles, and sleep-wake cycles determine things like ghrelin and other hormones, leptin, that regulate our appetite. All that is entangled. Now, the only way that can happen is through quantum biology. And in a way, our biology, the biology of other species, the sun, moon, stars, and our moods and our appetite and our thinking are all entangled in a non-local domain of awareness. Now, if any of you have objections to this, please let me know. Particularly if you're a scientist or a biologist, I'd like, and a quantum physicist, what is the objection? Is entangled not an amazing phenomenon that can only occur in a field of awareness, and our true identity is therefore the field and the knower of the field? And we're exploring that now. If you want me to explore it further, let me know. Thank you.